your senses?
Yes.
Also, we're both talking distracted.
True.
Feel all these pains in my finger.
Poor little boy.
And I do drink a lot of water.
I believe you. I don't know, what do you want me to say?
I just know.
I say I love you?
No, it's just... I'm addicted to caffeine, I guess, and...
yep, you guess.
I'm trying to justify why I don't need to stop.
I'm serious, I'm actually waiting for somebody to brew me moonshine.
Yes. Are you gonna drink it?
Yes. It's very good, it makes you stronger. Even my good character is addicted to, like, all the drugs.
So, remember that paint I had?
What paint? When?
Like, literal paint.
You mean the big jars?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Victor basically challenged me to learn how to paint.
Okay.
I think, I don't know if I was like outright disrespecting the fact that he was a painter, but I was kind of like, you know, you see 1,000 paintings and you're like, so what?
Yeah, sorry, I'm just confused because I saw, things are moving by themselves.
No, but do you know the feeling about, like, you've seen 1,000 paintings, you see one of your friend's paintings, and you're like, so what, who cares? First of all, that's not good compared to, like, Monet, and second of all... you're just so saturated. Painting just seems like such an everyday thing.
I suppose.
I
don't really feel like that.
Okay, but...
But it's okay that you do.
No, anyway, so Victor, like, said, alright, bitch, go buy some paint. Like, and he told me to teach
myself... He is a clever man.
He told me to teach myself how to paint. And I didn't get very far. But I think it's the same with music, like, especially with MP3s, like, there's just... so much music that you take for granted how difficult it was to make it.
Okay. I can agree with you then.
So, yeah. Anyways, I started thinking about this because, you know, I like Doug Stanhope, and he had a podcast where, like, two of his friends died.
Yeah, I heard it. I heard that one. That was really depressing.
Yeah. And,
It was actually a really nice podcast, kind of.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I can't listen to him anymore since I quit drinking. It would definitely not be a good idea,
yeah,
at least in the first year, to go back to listening to Doug Stanhope.
I would agree with you there.
Anyways, so, he had two friends who died, and they were musicians.
Yeah.
And,
didn't, like, one of them die and the other killed herself or something like that?
Yeah, I don't know. It's not important to go into the details. But, I was like, who are these jerks that get to be Doug Stanhope's friends? And then I found out they're musicians and I'm like, ah, layabouts!
Layabouts. You're funny a little boy.
Say this before, but I've held the opinion that the only legitimate job would be like either construction worker or farmer.
What about doctors? They're paying doctors. It's a legitimate job.
I just mean like if there is such a thing as like illegitimate work, like you know how I've waited in line for people before?
Yeah.
Like a lot of people would say, okay, you just got paid for doing nothing.
Yeah.
So,
it's still a job. People still needed you, like, wanted you to do it enough to pay you to do it.
Yeah. But, I don't know. So, what I'm saying is, like, I'm frustrated with myself because although I have gotten better at guitar, I want to be way, way better. I want to be like guitar solo, you know?
Yes, one day you will.
But so what I'm saying is like learning guitar is, you'd have to like separate the classification of legitimacy. It's like, music isn't necessary for us to be alive, as far as I know.
Sure makes being alive awesomer, though.
Yeah, it's like, it is something that, like, has happened since the dawn of time, if we are to believe history.
Yes.
But... I guess what I'm saying is, I'm starting to see art as more legitimate and not just, you
know. Good.
Did you say good?
Yeah.
Why do you say that?
It's good for you to think that it is legitimate.
I probably sound like a banker, like a businessman. Like, it's a big surprise to me that art is hard and people spend time and energy in it, and it's it's like worth something.
Yeah.
This should not be a surprise to me.
No.
But
it is, whatever. Oh, there it is. Can I go into this mine?
Yes.
It's apparently owned by Werner Herzog.
Seriously?
Well, it's Herzog's mine.
Oh. I think Werner Herzog was in an action movie recently. Like a really dumb Hollywood action movie.
Like as an actor?
Yeah.
That's weird.
I think he would like wore a fedora and shot someone or something.
Okay, if somebody was like, hey, do you want to be in my awful movie to wear a fedora and shoot somebody, wouldn't you say yes?
Yes.
Creepy at all. There are just a whole bunch of severed dolls' heads lying around. Went well. There is a stupid inbred hick who was trying to come and kill me, but then he accidentally stepped on one of his own trap lines and got blown apart. Because he's a stupid inbred hick.
Yes. Am I a stupid inbred hick?
No, you are a good inbred hick.
And why do I have such stupid teeth?
Because you are flat. Oh.
Thank you.
Okay. Forgot that I had stopped. I think they say meditation clears your head, like, what they said when I was a kid, cigarette, you take a puff of a cigarette, head rush, and then you do it so much, you stop getting the head rush. Anyways, I got a head rush, or a meditation buzz, or whatever kind of, like, what you want to call it, you know what it is.